Welcome to the Borisoglebsky Sports Palace in Romansko, Russia, some 30 kilometers southeast of Moscow, for the concluding action from the 2016 World University Badminton Championships. Action from both the ladies and men's singles finals coming up, but we're going to start with the men and what should be on paper a really good contest as we continue what has been a superb year of action from the whole host of World University Sports Championships staged by the international governing body, FISU. So the athletes taking to the court to be introduced to the crowd. The men's final featuring the number one seed, Sue Wang of Taipei, up against the number two seed, Sulfadi Zulkifli of Malaysia. Both players separated, incidentally, by just a couple of places on the world rankings at 35 and 37, respectively. And both men coming through their semi-final contests with relative ease. So the umpire, Mr. Temple, looking after this one. Russian service judge Kulikov. Just a quick look at how they made their way through. Wang beating Gyoke of China in his semi. And Zulkifli disposing of Lin Yu-Tien of Taipei. So Wang's compatriots. There may be a little bit of revenge to be had here. Well, closely matched in the rankings, closely matched in the seedings. So I said on paper, this one should be close, but we have to say Wang looking in very good form at this championships. And also in past encounters with Zulfadi Zulkifli, has enjoyed some decent results. So maybe coming into this one with a marginal upper hand, but we've had some very interesting results in the final stages of this competition, some real giant killing exploits. So don't write Zulkifli off yet. The man born originally in Los Angeles, now lives in Selangor, Malaysia. Former world junior champion is Zulfadi. Now studying sport and recreation at the University of Technology. He's the great British umpire. And Kulikov of Russia, the service judge, down in the chair on the floor. So best of three final for the gold medal at this World University Championships. All the other courts cleared away so that we can focus our attention on the show court, the TV court. In the red and yellow shirt, starting this first game nearest the camera, Sue Wang came through his semi-final against Kai 21-19, 21-11, so relatively straightforward. The man from Taipei, from Zulkifli's point of view, had a bit of a battle against Lin. 21-14, 22-20 was the final result for the world ranked number 37 Malaysian player. Well, both men in terms of their studies, both involved in physical education in some way. Sue more involved with the kinesiology side of things. But for Zulfadi, sport and recreation is his major. It was interesting to see what backgrounds the students have in terms of their studies. Not sure what influence that eventually has on their sport, but so many of the sports students do go on to play at international level. So it will be Wang to get this first game underway. The man in red with the service at the far end of the court in black, Zulfadi Zulkifli of Malaysia. Got his fan club in for this one. And away we go. Oh, beautiful angle on that opening smash from Wang. Just that little bit of cut on it to take it away from Zulkifli. And an angle worked, this time by the Malaysian. Wrong footing drive. Very nicely played. Well, you could see what Wang was trying to do there, getting onto the shuttlecock quickly. unfortunately for him, just overcooking that attacking shot at the net. Malaysian fans in force to support their man. Well, Wang trying to hold that position and holding it successfully, and that's just allowing him to pounce on anything from Zulkifli that isn't driven with sufficient power to get the angle. Great work again. Once more, Zulkifli not able to get enough height on that clear. And Wang pounces, making easy work of that with the jump smash. Well, he's only 3-2 up, but Wang looking the livelier of the two at the moment. Again, mistake. So that's a couple of unforced errors from Wang. To go with two very nicely put away shots. An extreme retrieve from the man in black at the far end of the court, Zulkifli. That was only ever going to come back as another opportunity for Wang to put it away. There it is, decent effort in defence, but left just about all the court open. So Wang, 4-3. The obligatory social media, very much part of the university championships. All of the competitors, the students encouraged to indulge in that. And I wonder if there'll be a few tweets going out about what's happening right now. I think there's a little bit of blood on court, and it's come from an injury that Zulkifli has picked up as this championships has gone on. He's played a lot of badminton here, and he's basically got a blister that keeps tearing. Didn't strap his hand too heavily, was hoping that that would be okay, but it has unfortunately torn again. So running repairs, doesn't look too serious, but a little bit of blood pumping when you're moving around the court like this, it's going to happen. And that's possibly when it happened. Yeah, the racket just going into the court and driving into the finger, and that's probably what has caused another split to the fingers of Zulkifli. So physio on, apply the plasters, get that sorted, the blood cleared up, and we'll be ready to go again. Yeah, so Kifli's going to be absolutely fine. Temple gets things underway after that medical timeout. Zulkifli with some repairs to a couple of troublesome blisters that he's got on his finger, and that's as comprehensive a put away as you're going to get. Wang once again pounces on a short shot at the net for a 5-3 cushion. A rally to Sabre. That's a fantastic effort from both men. Multiple shots, multiple tactics employed within the space of that one rally. No surprise to see the shuttlecock getting changed. And we saw Zulkifli try absolutely everything. A lot of short work at the net. And then tried to move his man deeper into court. But the court coverage at the moment from Wang, almost nonchalant. Zulkifli not getting enough on his smashes. So trying to rely on angles, but it's all a little bit too easy for Wang to cover at the moment. Well, he's got all the shots, says Wang.
7-3.
And he's starting to move away from Zulkifli. Let's hope that that tape to the Malaysian's hand isn't causing too many problems. But since the medical timeout, he certainly seems to have gone off the boil. 4-point deficit now. And again, Zulkifli stranded in the middle of the court, not really sure what to do. Can't seem to get enough depth on the clears to force Wang away from the net. But he reads that shorter stuff beautifully. Well, that was nearly a Watts moment, wasn't it, if that one had come back. Just missing as the shuttlecock tumbled off the top of the net tape. Zulkifli steals a point. That's what you're trying to do with those shots. Get them as close to the tape as possible. And if you can, tumble the shuttlecock off the top of the tape. And that's very difficult to play. But the problem for Zulkifli is that every time he tries one of those shorter shots, Wang is on it. And then when he reverts to a deeper defensive play, the clear, he's just not getting enough on it, and Wang's attacking potency is evident. Shuttlecock change again. They get through a fair few. Just to give you a clue about how many they get through, 8,400 shuttlecocks used in Rio. That's part of the badminton competition there. Too good again from Wang. He's all over it at the net. And a 10-4 lead in this opening game. Very difficult to see how Zulkifli is going to get out of jail here. It is all Wang at the moment. The man from Taipei dominating this men's final. It's been a fantastic display at the moment from Wang. Opportune attacking when the shots are a little bit high in the front of the court. Zulkifli has tried to keep it tight to the net, but Wang's been all over it. And then every time his opponent has played something deeper, Wang's ability in terms of his attack is superb. That's another very good, very aggressive forehand. Reading just about everything at the moment that Zulfari Zulkifli is trying to do. Out again, long. Zulkifli sticking with that flat approach to his shots. That's the first time he's gone aerial for a while. It's too good from Wang. He's worked out his angles. He's reading Zulkifli like a book. And at the moment, the man from Malaysia powerless. 15-4, the lead for Wang. That's some coverage from the man in the red shirt. And Zulkifli will be kicking himself because there was a chance to put the shuttlecock deep into court and away from Wang, but just couldn't get the elevation on it. How's this for coverage? Brilliant defensive play from Zulkifli. But Wang counters. Equally impressive. Nice angle. Seen too little of that from the Malaysian. The number two seed here at this tournament. And another shuttle change. Once the feathers get damaged, the lacquered feathers, then the change is made. And they're straight into the action. It's good. At last, a bit of reward for Zulkifli trying to hold that position in the middle of the court. Something for the Malaysian fans to cheer about. If you've ever been lucky enough to play against a top international badminton player, you will know just how difficult they can make things out there on court, just how deceptive these shots are. When they are smashing, it's fast and it's powerful. Just like that from Wang. But they also add this element of disguise where they can cut across the shuttlecock, produce what looks like it's going to be a speedy shot, but ends up flat-footing your opponent. Very impressive. And then when you combine that with the sheer athleticism, the court coverage of the top players is sensational. And they can do this all day. Working that line. Wang. Yeah, he really has focused at the moment on the forehand of Zulkifli. And once again, the man from Malaysia finds himself face down on the court. Lovely disguised jump smash. Let's hope there's not more blood on the court from that earlier injury to Zulkifli. Great shot. Wonderful shot of the player in the air. Full extension, gaining extra height from the jump. 2 points away then from the first game for Wang, the number one seed. Absolutely dominating the number two seed. Came in as marginal favourite on previous results, but didn't expect to see such a comprehensive victory in game one. Not sure where Zulkifli goes from here. So 26 up, 14 game points, and taken just like that. And I have to say, in terms of this scoring system, that is an absolute thrashing. Wang leads 1-0.
In 2016, University Sport goes on a journey across the world to share its values and its commitment to athletic and academic excellence. This is a year of FISU World University Championships. More than 8,000 students will compete at the 34 events organized in 25 countries, sharing and chasing their long-held dreams. We are International University Sports Federation. Follow your champions. FISU, today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
Welcome back to the men's final here at the World University Badminton Championships in Ramensko in Russia, just southeast of Moscow. Game one went easily to Wang at the far end of the court now in the red and yellow shirt, and normal service resumed by Wang, pouncing on that shorter shot from the Malaysian Zulkifli. 21-6 in the first game. The number one seed thumping the number two seed in the opener. And It's been delightful badminton to watch from the point of view of Wang and the Taipei fans. But I have to say, as a contest, it hasn't been great. So Kifley, to me, looks a little jaded. Nothing wrong with that smash, though. Again, Wang gets his distances right. His angles have been superb today. So Kifley has tried to hold a strong position in the middle of the court, work from that. He's tried to keep things very flat. But Wang, more often than not, has managed to read those particular tactical shots. Factor in his speed around the court, but also his ferocious smashing power. Wang has been the complete package. That's better. So Kifley, nice and calm in this rally, and just as I say that, overcooks it. Short work at the net. If you get to it and take it high,
four,
just dab it over the top of that net tape, you're in business. And at last, so Kifley gives Wang a dose of his own medicine. It's more pouncing on that short shot. That's what Wang's been doing to him all day. Two good shots back to back. This time the smash setting up the opportunity, and Zulkifli backing himself to come to the net and put it away. Still with a healthy cushion. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant from Wang.
Six, three.
So calm. That's a real skill to be able to remain calm when those smashes are raining down at you. Oh, tremendous. Rally. Zulkifli just couldn't put it away. Diving this way and that. That's tremendous work. Incredible defense. Four in a row. And then the error from Zulkifli.
Okay, thank you.
Oh, just overcooked that no-look smash. Got another delay for umpire Temple to oversee.
No, play.
Maybe just a couple of spots of sweat to be cleared up, play. And then both players told no change of shuttlecock, just get on with it. Lovely. That's what I mean about Wang reading the play. Just ghosted into position on that Zulkifli angle. and was on it and putting it away before Zulkifli was even able to find his feet and recover. Zulkifli this time able to find the angles good enough to get it past this amazing defence from Wang. There it is, the look one way, hit the other. Cuts the shuttlecock into some decent angles. Not the hardest smasher out there on court, but certainly makes it work for him when he gets it right. So Zulkifli still with a lot of work to do. 4 points down on Wang in this second game. Brilliant. Hitting inside to out this time.
Service over. Nine.
There's that deception. This could have gone either way, and he just cuts this time inside on the shot. Sends it spiraling past his opponent. Very impressive Wang today. More traditional defensive shots there, clearing to the back of the court. Both players trying to work their opponent deep. But again, another unforced error from Zulkifli. 3 point to his opponent. Good shot into the body. Doesn't always have to be wide of your opponent. Zulkifli cramping up Wang here. But you've got to have enough pace on that shot. Just think it took a little nibble on the tape as it came over. That's probably enough to get that away. Look how flat and how early Wang is trying to take this shuttlecock. Again, more accurate clearing work in defence, but a little cut going into the net from Wang. We've seen very few mistakes from him. There were a couple early on in game one. But since then, the man from Taipei has been almost flawless. He would like that one back, though. Almost embarrassed reaction from Wang. This time they are allowed to change the shuttlecock. To just take a breather and get to the towels.
Okay, thank you.
Pretty humid in this sports hall and plenty of sweat droplets coming down onto the court, and as good as these sports floors are, like anything really, you get some moisture on it and that can cause a loss of contact between the bottom of the sports shoe and the sports floor, and you'll see anybody go over under those circumstances. So very important the moisture is removed. Fault called. He's been very strict today as umpire Temple. It's the service judge that has made the call against Wang. So Zulkifli reducing that lead to 3 points. Is there a way back into this final for him? Not if Wang keeps smashing like that. Made his ground very nicely to the back of the court, got airborne, and then once again hitting inside to out for a clean winner. Leads comfortably 11-7.
In 2016, University Sport goes on a journey across the world to share its values and its commitment to athletic and academic excellence. This is a year of FISU World University Championships. more than 8,000 students will compete at the 34 events organized in 25 countries, sharing and chasing their long-held dreams. We are International University Sports Federation. Follow your champions. FISU. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
Well, FISU Student Sport has provided us with some terrific entertainment this year. And there's more to come. The remainder of this men's singles final. Oh, stunning pickup. Now, if that had been on a volleyball court, it would have been called a pancake. Sliding the racket underneath the descending shuttlecock and actually getting it airborne. Brilliant work from Zulkifli to start with, but look at that. What a pickup. But from that position, not even Wang could get there. Good put away from Zulkifli, who's shown some nice glimpses of recovering a bit of form in game two, but I don't know, has he got enough to really stay in there? Is that on the line? Well, initially it looked good, but it has gone to Zulkifli, so just wide. Oh, that was actually more than just wide. My apologies, on the first angle it looked closer than it was. So a couple of mistakes from Wang, just letting Zulkifli back in. Both men still trying to stay fairly flat. First high clear from Zulkifli, but very reluctant to go there. Now, chance, not taken. No, that's a shame. I think he was in two minds, Zulkifli, as he played that defensive shot down the line. Just look at the hesitation and ends up flicking it wide of the court by some distance. Another change of shuttlecock. Nine. Wang maintains a comfortable lead. Not as comfortable as game one, but still no danger and another error from Zulkifli. 13-9. Good work. Zulkifli reading the next short shot, diving in. And just playing it as soon as it came over the net.
Service over, 10-13.
Needs to make this work. Zulkifli needs another couple of points here just to get some pressure onto Wang. Brilliant. Very good from Wang. Yes, the pickup was excellent from Zulkifli, but the point is Wang is building the pressure. The smash then on very quickly to the defensive response of the Malaysian. And that usually is enough for the point. Well, Wang being made to cover some serious ground in game two. He was able to dominate the space a little more easily in the first, but he really is moving in this second one. We've seen some awesome defense from him. Just keeps repeating the same smash, inside to out. So Zulkifli reading it a little better now.
16-10.
Still difficult to stay in the rally under that pressure. So Kifley this time able to engineer the opening. Like a game of chess, some of these rallies, the players thinking several shots in advance. There's that court coverage I was talking about. That is brutal stuff from Wang. All over it. Brilliant. So Kifley trying not to give Wang the angles. But eventually he got into the rally, started to move his opponent one way then the other. And it's another one of those inside to out telling smashes. Not sure if So Kifley's heart is still in this. Looks a beaten man to me, 6 points down. Done it again, same smash again. A little bit more power on this one. Played it a little bit faster. Both men happy to change the shuttlecock, and I suspect gasp a few breaths of air. They are a thing of beauty. A brand new shuttlecock out of the tube. They get beaten up pretty quickly.
Service over, 12, 18.
Oh, that gap that So Kifley was working so hard to close has extended. And we are approaching the now or never scenario for the man nearest the camera. It looks like a silver for the Malaysian at the moment. He's having to keep it so tight at the net, because if he doesn't, Wang pounces. And that's putting just a little bit too much pressure on his play at close quarters. Well, you have to go back about 20 shots for a phenomenal backhand from Wang to stay in the rally. But once So Kifley had control of the space, then just a matter of time before he could dominate. Good forehand smash and another diving attempt. Wang down, but certainly not out.
Thank you. Players on court, please.
Well, game two been much more of a spectacle.
13,
some marvellous rallies, some real athleticism. And a certain amount of bravery as well to throw yourself full length like that. So Kifley serves, 6 points down. Yeah, that was inevitable. Half court. With that clear, time for Wang to set up, get into the air and hit that jump smash. So once again, on comes the mop as both players take a breather. But from So Kifley's point of view, this is has a certain feel of inevitability about it. Seven championship points. And a little touch on the net, I'm afraid, from Zulkifli. Oh, that's a really unfortunate way to lose. But let's not take anything away from Wang. Xue Wang from Taipei with a fabulous performance. And the world number 35 dominating the world number 37. And the seeding has gone to plan. The number one seed beating the number two seed. 21-6, 21-13. That is a convincing win in a final at this level. And Xue Wang wins the gold medal here at this World Student Badminton Championships. And he's won it in style. Well, Taipei have dominated over the years in various events. But it's thumbs up all the way for Wang. A very, very good victory against Zulkifli, who played his part but just couldn't quite live with it. And it's just an unfortunate finish as he lunges into the net, catches it, and that's called a fall. Wang takes the championship.
In 2016, University Sport goes on a journey across the world to share its values and its commitment to athletic and academic excellence. This is a year of FISU World University Championships. More than 8,000 students will compete at the 34 events organized in 25 countries, sharing and chasing their long-held dreams. We are International University Sports Federation. Follow your champions. FISU, today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.